Spanish 1, Global Challenges, Vocabulary Words 6 through 10. I'm going to say each of these words in English, then Spanish, and clap. And I'd like you to repeat with me, okay? Number 6, energy.
Energía.
Energy. Energía. Number 7, the electricity.
La electricidad.
The electricity.
La electricidad.
Number 8, ecological.
Ecológico.
Ecological. Ecológico. Number 9, fire.
Fuego.
Fire.
Fuego.
And number 10, fire.
Incendio.
Fire. Incendio. Let's look at 6, energy. We've talked before about a lot of times if an English word ends in Y, the Spanish equivalent has an I. We've talked about the word for Mary is Maria, the Y turns into I. The word for day is dia. And here's another one, energy turns into energía. I've also mentioned that Spanish words that end in IA have an accent. Now, I used to say every Spanish word that ends in IA have an accent, but I've realized there are a few that don't have accents. But about 95% of the time, if a Spanish word ends in the letters IA, there's an accent over the I. Now, electricity. Here we go. It's very, very similar. Remember, green means it's almost exactly the same in both languages, okay? Now, we say electricity, they say electricidad, D-A-D. Now, we've mentioned before that words that end in D-A-D, like the truth is la verdad, university is la universidad. Words that end in D-A-D are always feminine. And the way I remembered it, but my dad's not feminine. See, this looks like the English word dad. So it's la verdad, the truth. La universidad, the university. And la electricidad. Ecological or eco-friendly is very easy. It's almost exactly the same. But notice, there's an accent mark. If a word has no accent mark, we stress the next to last letter, like fuego, la verdad, chimichanga, amigo. But the accent mark says, hey, don't stress the next to last vowel here. Don't say ecológico. This accent mark says, stress me, ecológico. So again, accent mark is a big arrow that says, don't stress the vowel you normally stress, stress me. Now, there are two words for fire. Fuego and incendio. Fuego is small, like a campfire or whatnot, real small fire. Okay, and incendio is a big blaze or a big like forest fire, like the fire that burned San Francisco or the Great Chicago Fire. All right, how are we going to remember that fuego is a little fire? Well, you're on a camping trip and they say, hey, why don't you go start the fire? Or at the end of the camping trip, why don't you go put out the fire? Fire in English has an F-E. Fuego in Spanish is an F-E. So why don't you go start the fire, or why don't you go put out the fire? Now, fire incendio is a big event, like a city burns or a building burns. Now, you might have heard the word incendiary. The protester made incendiary remarks. Incendiary remarks are things that are said that fire a group up, that get them all fired up. Also, in the military, there are several types of grenades. There are fragmentation grenades that, like, are anti-personnel. There are concussion grenades that go boom and, like, stun people. And there are incendiary grenades. An incendiary grenade is used to burn up a Jeep or a building. So an incinerator burns things up. So a little fire is the little word fuego, and a big fire, like a big forest fire or something like that, is the big word incendio. All right, let me give you a chance to quiz yourself here. I'm going to cover up the Spanish, look at the English, and say the Spanish equivalents out loud, or even better, look at the English and write the Spanish equivalents down on a piece of paper. Okay, make sure you know these before you go on. This has been Spanish 1, Global Challenges, Vocab 6 through 10.